the backward troops to deal with it, which is what should have happened. I'm just, you know, I don't want the Nazis to win, but I'm just saying that's the tactic you gotta use. You gotta surround the fucker. And there's like fucking 12 tactical nukes going off all around you. And it's just, I always found it I always found the name to just be so awful. The Red Star Alliance. Why are they communist again all of a sudden? But I don't know. Just random babbling at this point. And now I'm done, so you don't have to worry about it.
That's cool. Thanks to Russian help, the advancements against Thailand are proceeding well. Come on, get in there. Take Hanoi from Field Marshal P. That's it.
Field Marshal Petey, I call him.
Or Field Marshal Petovsky, as the Russians say.
Field Marshal Baderpaderpaderp. The derpiest of field marshals. I guess
fucking broken.
Oh, wow.
Those counters. And I guess... guarantee you with certainty that Caucasus is the same way.
Oh, it looks like the French also want to keep South Africa as a colony.
With UOB keeping Cape Town.
You're not real socialists, you liars!
Why the hell am I getting vision of this place?
Oh, there's a Russian.
Oh yeah, that's right. Random Russian fleet here. Okay, Transmer surrender in hopeless war. Took them long enough.
Good for Russia. They got their old piece of land back.
But can they keep it? Because Japan is... I don't know,
Good old Liberia still has the Whig Party.
Yep. Socialists gain majority in Central America. What a surprise!
God, he looks so fucking derpy. He's looking at the picture of whoever's taking him like, what? And then someone just snapped it while one of his eyes was half closed.
Is that, I'm high.
This foreign minister looks like a progenitor for fucking Sarah Palin.
Oh. I guess.
That stupid look in the fucking glasses, I don't know, I put it together in my head.
Am I insane, or is that chief of the Air Force a West Point cadet? I mean, look at that uniform. Oh.
Maybe.
Denikin's dead, so now the Russian army's got a new leader. Chuikov. Alright.
Good for Chuikov. As long as his name isn't Makarov. Something's fishy about him. Damn, the Bartia commune is making doomstacks that'll never ever do anything.
Now they don't need to do anything, now that the Princely Federation just kind of rolled over like in 2 seconds and Delhi would just got stomped. And they got nothing else to do. I mean, do they have anything to take over the Madras Republic? Because if they do, it hasn't happened yet.
I don't know why they don't have an inclination to do it and reunite India. AI thinking outside the box is hard.
Oh wait, yeah, you guys are defending. Oh! Okabe is actually bringing in some Japanese troops to the Thai front.
Defend for Stalingrad!
Too but bad.
We're not near Stalingrad.
General, what is Stalingrad?
You mustn't let them reach the Volga. I know, but what's Stalingrad?
Oh my god, they were defeated. Well, can we at least curl around Vietnam?
There is no curling around Nam. Where do I remember that from?
I don't know.
It just came in my head, and I swear that's like from a game or something.
I agree with you, but
it's gonna bother me for a while.
I ain't the faintest idea.
Advance, glorious, victorious Russo-Chinese hordes! Advance! Oh yeah, so, you two Mongolians, I guess.
Yeah, Mongolians, just kinda stand around in Mongolia land and look menacing.
We will charge the Japanese tanks with our horses!
In the mountains, because their tanks will be ineffective, maybe.
Oh, for Genghis Khan and Genghis Khan the Second! Even though he's kind of rotting in a Russian prison somewhere.
But there shall never be a Genghis Khan the Third.
Can I be Genghis Khan the Third?
Feng Chin Cook surrendered, so oh. Now I just inherited all their territories.
Now you need to just cut off those those Japanese troops there, if you can somehow get the, if you and the Russians can somehow, get their ports. And I'm sure the Russians are gonna have a good old time going to Korea. Yeah, the Japanese are screwed, unless they make a massive breakout out of their ass. Is that Russian fighting Russian?
Right here.
There was like a Russian versus Russian thing on the screen, I swear.
I don't know where that would be. Transmer's already been taken back.
I don't know what I was seeing.
Alright, I'm gonna send you guys to the Thai frontier. And you guys are... Why did I... Oh, okay, we still got a division there, good. Had me worried there for a second, you fools.
I forgot, yeah, I played as Russia a few times and created the Chinese Republic, and whenever you take over other territories they have cores on, they just immediately get it. And I know that pissed me off at one point because I wanted to actually integrate Manchuria, but I was like, yeah, fuck it.
Yeah.
So yeah, my worries there, even though I thought were intelligent, were actually dumb.
I remember one time I was playing as Soviet Russia, or a variant of the Soviets, and I basically took over China and made the communist China.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
How do you make communist China in this game?
You gotta take over China as basically one of the Soviets.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's... I don't know, I fucking heard you wrong, I'm an idiot. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, and that's basically it.
Huh. Interesting. Do you remember who their leaders were? Since Mao isn't around. Oh right, isn't it like some sort of political rival of Mao's?
Yeah. Yeah, I think it actually might have been. I can't remember off the top of my head, but...
Yeah, you know, communists are always so great, you know, they always go around killing political rivals when they always espouse how socialists should work together and whatnot.
Yeah, and socialists should really work together to weed out the not-so-socialist-socialists and then kill them for their lack of vision.
What everyone should remember is that they're all politicians, so they're all awful.
They all care about their own interests first, and if your interests happen to coincide with theirs, then good job. You managed to play the system.
You may get a cookie.
Half a cookie. Budget cuts are bad. Oh yeah, great, since I annexed that other place, I got their tech trees, and now get the Turkestani Air Corps to provide doctrines for the Chinese Grand Air Fleet.
What is this shit? You're working with technology that the Wright brothers would laugh at. Oh man, that's so bad.
And some of you may be asking how that's possible. Thanks a lot, Russia.
They'll take it back for you.
Yeah. I really shouldn't be complaining. Russia has been the greatest help in making this campaign go unbelievably well for how it's going. You see this shit?
Apparently, Russia, when you unleashed them, were just like, alright, boys, we're going in!
We're going in full throttle. That'll keep those Thai fighters off our back.
Drop your pants and lower your undies. We're going balls deep, boys!
Ooh. What? The premiere of The Spring River Flows East. Directed by these two dudes. The Spring River Flows East is a two-part epic movie depicting the hardships of a poor working-class couple during the trials and tribulations of the Chinese unification. Portraying the corruption that greed and power holds over the people, the movie's message has been interpreted by many as a direct attack upon the policies of the Liberal Party. However, the film has been a smashing success at the box office, as well as with the critics. I say
so. It's about the poor working class and their struggle, but it's also an attack on liberals?
That's what some people think.
Okay, that's confusing.
Or the policies of the Liberal Party, whether they're liberals or not, is yet to be determined.
I think you're controlled by a conservative at this point, at this juncture. Yeah, you're more to the right. Okay, that was weird. Interesting, but weird.
Maybe because the right control things, maybe they had a hand in the film?
Well, that would be the logical conclusion.
Ain't nothing but a Danang thing.
Ain't nothing but a Danang thing. Saigon. Shit, I'm still in Saigon. Oh yeah, these provinces are still technically owned by Germany.
Oh good lord.
And it's like, now there's like a whole bunch of other people fighting over them, like, okay, whatever Germany, you meant everything here a billion years ago, not anymore.
Oh, you just trapped a shit ton of Japanese troops.
They will not survive.
Damn, it's gonna be a bloodbath.
Oh boy. What's Russia gonna do with Korea, I wonder? Are they gonna let it go?
Alright, go ahead and say the Tojo joke.
Gonna have to get moving, or else Tojo and Fuckface are gonna counterattack. Oh my god, why did you make me say that? Okay, for those of you who don't know, there was an HBO miniseries called The Pacific, I think. Basically, the Pacific Front's version of Band of Brothers. And there was a scene where they were doing mortar tests, and the one guy misfired, and it was actually supposed to be kind of like a serious moment because the sergeant in charge was chewing this guy's ass out because he missed the shot and instead killed two of the friendly dummies. And then the sergeant goes, "You just killed two of your best friends while Tojo and Fuckface over there continued to hose down our line." And basically there were these two dummies One of them had a sign over his neck that said Tojo, and the other one had a sign over his neck that said Fuckface. And yeah.
Oh man. Tojo and Fuckface, the greatest love story ever told.
Better love story than Twilight.
GG. Well. Excuse me, that rule applies to almost anything and anybody.
Even the Star Wars prequels.
Shut
up.
But.
But not going there. At least not for this video. This video is about alternate history Earth where where totalist France controls a German Union led by Ernst Thälmann and Russian Tsar and Chinese Republic are invading a greater Thailand. Another nuclear attack at Ukraine.
Stop nuking Ukraine!
This wasn't even an important province. It didn't even have any victory points or really any IC or anything.
They haven't even nuked Kiev, and they obviously have the ability to. They've nuked a province, like, above them.
Yeah, they did.
This is what I mean. The AI is stupid when it uses nukes.
They're just content with bombing Kiev with conventional weapons, though. Just go with that.
It's fun that way. Well, China's sure as hell looking like modern-day China.
Well, they got defeated. Alright.
Defeated.
Defeated. Okay, I can only release Laos at this point in time. Okay, thank you. Terrakin, I believe that guy is, leading the 12th Corps. I was wondering when somebody would take that place back.
Now you only need two more provinces and you're officially bigger than modern-day China because of your advances in the south.
Well, I will go back to modern-day China after I pretty much puppetized everything here.
Yeah, I figured that's what you're gonna do, but I'm just saying.
Yeah, I know.
You have succeeded where the PRC has failed. Somehow.
Made sensible government policies and got the people to actually like me instead of forced them to.
And
something else?
Going into war after war after war and winning. Winning. Winning is key.
Oh, wow. How cute, Japan. You're gonna attack from Port Arthur. I'll just send my 6th stack here to Dandong and hold you back.
Dandong? What are you talking about Dandong for? Don't talk about Dandong, man. Yeah, after that massive stack got murdered up there in the neck to Manchuria, Japan just lost everything.
I guess that's what Japan gets for putting all their... I guess that's what they get for putting all their eggs in one basket. I had originally thought about saying that that's what they get for putting all their rice bowls in one place.
Wow.
But then I decided against it, and I'll just go with the regular saying.
And yet you said what you were going to say anyways.
But I didn't actually say it. I was only going to say what it would have been, but I didn't actually say it. I may have said it.
So it was a Commander N what if.
Yes, a what if that you got to see in this universe.
How fitting I should be here to witness it.
And Japan took that from Germany. Oh, that's right, Philippines is still a puppet of the USA because they didn't go into civil war. Keep forgetting that. Like how the Philippines has that event where they could give Japan a naval base if Japan, like, asks nicely.
Another two divisions slaughtered, yeah.
give up, General Nagata. Your pathetic, Mokogo Keishindan is no match for my infantry division.
Them damn Russians sweeping down into Korea like they always wanted to. And you taking a piece of the pot.
And with this pot, I shall put a chicken in it, and many more like it, to feed all of China.
You're making Thailand cry after all those years of fighting Germany and Cambodia and actually winning, and now you're just taking it all away.
Oh yeah, Thailand. Did you lose a lot of people to Burma and Germany? Well, too bad. You're now gonna lose it all to me, China.
Damn you! You man!
Because China will grow larger.
We shall call upon the endless hordes of the commune, but they won't do shit.
Oh wow, these guys are losing. And they already lost just as I say that. Okay.
Yeah. All your troops are moving through dense-ass jungle right at this point, so...
Yep.
Oh god, your cav units must hate you right now. Why in the ever-loving hell am I moving a horse through this damn jungle?
Because war demands it.
War, huh? What is it good for? Absolutely nothing.
War, what is it good for? Taking back the lands that we had wanted because some fucknugget decided to screw up the referendum for returning the lands to our control. We didn't want to, but he had to muck up the entire process of the plebiscite, and now we have to fight.
And supposedly Tokyo was all for it, and then they weren't, so they also are indecisive, apparently.
Indecisive, yet decisive enough to send troops and fight anyway.
Very true.
Alright. Go to Pyongyang. I'm tired of all this sitting around.
Oh, Yamashita. Not committing any sort of war crimes lately, have we?
Ah, General P. We meet again at last.
I'm like the only real general this country has, shut up.
When
I'm also head of government. Or you.
No, that's... Yeah, the chief of staff and the army.
And head of intelligence.
Wait. Oh yeah, it is.
It's never good to send a guy with three cabinet positions out to the front lines, I think.
Perhaps, but hey, it all worked out, I suppose. Well, not really, but... So this guy really believes in the logistics and guns and butter. And mass
guns,
combat,
butter,
too.
Logistics.
The three things you need for a war, son.
That's why I use UPS.
UPS. We'll deliver a war to you tomorrow. At no cost to you.
Except maybe your life.
Or an additional 2% shipping and delivery cost. Because we are greedy, evil fuckers.
Greed. Your greed will be your downfall.
Yeah, tell it to the bank, Buster Brown.
No, I'll talk to my mom.
Well, this is going to be a dredge until you reach Singapore.
Yeah. This is going to take quite...
Unless Thailand just GGs at some point.
It might. We don't know.
What's the capital of... The kids at my school are so stupid. You know the Thailand game?
Yeah.
Where, you know, what's the capital of Thailand? Boom, Bangkok. Oh, so goddamn stupid. But my classmates were so dumb that they asked me what was the capital of Taiwan.
What's the capital of Taiwan?
Taipei.
Yeah.
And then they'd say Bangkok, and you know what happens then, but God, Jesus. Good lord. What's the capital of Germany? Paris?
Does anyone teach national geography anymore, anywhere? No, we really that retarded?
Not in UB Kinsey's School of the Arts.
Oh, okay. Alright, we have just released Vietnam.
It's apparently the Kingdom of Vietnam because it's got His Royal Majesty in it.
Yeah, His Royal Majesty Bao
Dai.
And
that's what I always said to Bao Dur, die.
Aw, you too, man?
Bao, just die. General, I don't want to talk about the war. Now let's talk about the war.
Yeah, I don't want to talk about the thing, but I want to talk about the thing. So let's talk about the thing. How was the thing?
I like Tim play through Louise and I don't want to talk about the war. And they start talking about it, and Tim's like, you brought it up!
Bulgaria says no to new healthcare.
Let them die in the streets.
I guess Nicola Care wasn't very popular, so they couldn't get it passed.
Nicola Care.
Brazil now has actually put this guy in this time with the new syndicalist. The gangster looking dude.
Here, yeah.
And they've actually got some good pushes against La Plata, who also got new leaders. These guys apparently. So, yeah. UOB landed in Madagascar. Germany's running out of places to hide.
Yeah, but they got all those islands out in the Pacific. Those tiny shits with victory points are going to take them forever to get to.
Yeah. And more than likely, Japan will get to them first. Maybe.
Yeah. And the Kaiser will be relegated to ruling an empire of one island with his little beach resort.
Alright, there's Laos.
No, not our Laos province. We need it for stuff.
For science.
For science.
Science is of the devil.
Possibly. These are the questions worth asking.
Or are they?
Oh!
Whatever the hell that was.
I don't know.